There is a useful relationship between the infinite unbounded areas and the finite unbounded areas for all except for the special case of 1 over x. So we've kind of summarized it here. So if n is less than negative 1, so for example, 1 over x squared, 1 over x cubed, so when as the denominator power gets larger, so we're looking at the blue case here. And when the denominator power is large, it means that it's going to this denominator tends to infinity much quicker, and it's going to, as we look at the y values as we approach infinity, it's going to come down towards zero very quickly. And what ends up happening is because the speed at which this approaches zero is much quicker, this area tends to be finite. Now, the converse then is true when we look at the other side of that arbitrary point. So if it's finite on one side, this area against the asymptote then is infinite. Okay, so for 1 over x squared, 1 over x cubed, this is the case. So this side would be infinite. This area is infinite, whereas this area is finite. Now, the opposite is then true if the power is between negative 1 and 0. So for example, square roots, square root x. So what happens then is that in this case, the denominators, or for any roots, the denominator will tend to infinity slower than 1 over x. And if that's the case, then that means that this goes towards 0 much slower, and it leaves a big gap in here, and that makes this unbounded area infinite. And then if this area in here is unbounded, area in here is infinite, the area on the opposite side then becomes finite. Okay, so this unbounded area against the asymptote then becomes finite. So in this case, it is the reverse of that. So this is a very useful concept to be able to use when we look at series and differentials. And this is a little bit later on, but for series and differentials, we know that any high powers tends towards zero very quickly, so this area pinches off and becomes finite. For these denominators that are not very powerful, they tend towards zero slower, and it does not pinch off the area quick enough, and this area ends up being infinite. So this is a very useful thing to know when we start looking at series and differentials. And this is all for everything except for that one special case of 1 over x, and that 1 over x is a special case.